Hello, welcome to Vigilant Online Workshop. This is Navin. So the topic under discussion is registry hacking. Before we begin with registry hacking, let us first see what registry is. Now, registry is your system's database. It holds all the important information about your system's operating system, all the system related configuration, the settings, the options, even the changes that you bring in your PC, a part of it is reflected back in your registry. Now let us see what a registry looks like. To open your registry, go to run and type regedit, R-E-E-G edit. It is the registry editor. So this is how your registry looks like. There are two panels, left and right. Your left panel has some folders. Now these folders are called keys in registry. So within a key you will find another set of keys, and within that another. These might keep on going, and as soon as you've reached the last one, you'll find the contents within them in the right side panel, and these are known as the registry elements. The registry elements hold the important information. If you do anything in this, the change is reflected in your system. So registry hacking is basically tweaking your registry, changing your registry values in such a way that you can achieve something which is beyond the creator's original purpose. Like your system was supposed to do something and you're going beyond limits. That is what you're going to do with registry. Basically, you are going to optimize your system's performance using registry hacking. Now, let me show you a simple trick. This is your desktop context menu, right? So I'm going to add a shortcut for any app in this desktop context menu. Like suppose I am to add a shortcut for Notepad in this particular menu. Okay, for that you have to go to your registry, navigate to this particular path that I'm about to show you now, hkey classes root, go to directory, within that go to background and then shell. The path is clearly mentioned over here. Hkey classes root, directory, background, shell. Now within shell, create a key by the name Notepad. Name it whatever you want, like whichever app you wish to create, name it accordingly. Right click on Notepad, create another key within your Notepad, and this time name it command. Now this is mandatory, you have to name it command, all in small letters. The registry is very case sensitive. Certain things need to be done exactly the way they should be, so follow the steps I show you and then you're good to go. So far you've created a shortcut in your context menu. Now to complete this procedure, what you have to do is go to your C drive, Windows, System32. Here you'll find the executable file of your Notepad. This is your notepad.exe file, your Notepad's executable file. Shift right click on it, you'll find an option copy as path. Go back to your registry, open the command and you'll find the registry element in the right side panel. Click on it and paste your path over here. That's it. clicking on notepad, we'll open the notepad. For system pre-configured apps, you'll find all the executable files in your C drive, Windows, System 32. And for other apps, just mention the path wherever you save it, just mention the path and then you're good to go. That was one trick. Now I'll show you another trick. I'll show you a trick in which you can hide a drive. These are your drives. Suppose if I want to hide a drive. Now this will come in handy for all you guys out there. What you have to do is go to your registry. Go to this particular path, HK local machine, software, Microsoft, Windows, current version, policies, and within that you are supposed to create a new key by the name Explorer. Now this should be as it is, I have told you. In the Explorer, create a new dword file. You can see there are options, a lot of options, dword file, 32-bit, qword, 64-bit. Now you just keep in mind, you always have to work with this dword file only. You have to open a dword file irrespective of your system's configuration, whether it is a 32-bit device or a 64-bit. The dword file that you just created, name it no drives. Exactly the way I've told you. N should be capital, D should be capital, there should be no space. Click on no drives, decimal value, and for D drive you have to type the value 8. I'll show you the list of values that you have to type for various drives. For D drive I am to type 8. That's it. Now for the changes to take effect, you have to restart your PC. The next time you restart, this drive will be hidden. I assure you that. Now I'll give you the list of values. For C drive, type the value 4. For D drive, type the value 8. For E drive, type the value 16. For F drive, type the value 32, and so on. Do try this and you'll see the change. Just restart your PC and you'll see the change. Now I'll show you another trick. Now the trick that I'm about to show you is quite often used in corporate level. In companies, in huge companies, we have server rooms, the server computers. Suppose an intruder enters into that server room. Now what he can do, he can simply use a pen drive to extract the information from your server computer, or likewise he can also infect your server computers with a virus that he brought it around. So in that case, what they do is they simply disable all the USB ports. So that is what I'm going to show you now, disabling the USB ports. This might also come in handy for you guys, all you students out there. Go to registry, local key, local machine, HK local machine, system, current control set, policies, no, sorry, services that go to USB hub. You can see USB hub over here. The USB hub goes right side panel and double click on start. You can see the value 3 over here. Just change it to 4. Okay. And for the changes to take effect, restart your PC. The next time you restart your PC, any external device, your computer won't allow for it to get connected. So to enable access again, all you have to do is go to this particular path and click on start. All you have to do is simply change the value back from 4 to 3. That's it. So these are certain tricks. If you want more such tricks, Google it. Just type how to do so and so using registry hacking. You will find ample number of tricks. And just explore this registry hacking concept and have fun. Thank you.